thanks for stopping by for another episode of Bernardo's Tech Blog. A few months ago, I made a video showing how to convert a satellite dish into a parabolic solar cooker. And in that video, I promised that I would make another video that demonstrated the use of this, and so that's what I'm going to do today. Now, the first thing I want to show you is this little contraption I made here that allows me to hang a cooking vessel in the focal point of the parabolic solar oven. That's something I hadn't finished up at the time I made the other video, so I'm going to go into detail of what I did there. Right, the first thing I did is found a stick that fits perfectly in this little aluminum channel here that was part of the dish, and then I drilled a bunch of holes in it that allowed me to adjust it up and down as much as I want, and there happened to be a hole already drilled in this aluminum channel here, so I was able to put a just drop a nail in that hole and put it through one of the holes in the stick to adjust it up or down. Now on the top you can see here I have just a hook that I put on the end, and then I have a chain that goes down to the cooking vessel. Now this is just an ordinary 1-quart pan that I got at Walmart, and I selected it for a couple of reasons. First, because it's a 1-quart pan, that means it's pretty small. I knew going into this project that this is a pretty small dish for a parabolic solar cooker, so I know that I won't be able to do a lot of food at one time, and so for that reason I want a small pan. The other thing is I don't want to block a lot of the sun, because since I have a small dish, obviously I want to have as much surface area reflecting back to the pan as possible. So for this kind of dish, a 1-quart pan seems like the obvious choice. The other thing is I wanted something that was pretty lightweight. This pan is pretty lightweight, and that makes so it can heat up rather quickly. The other thing that led me to buy this one is that it's stainless steel. I've never been a fan of that Teflon coating. It seems like after you use it for a while it starts to flake and you wonder what exactly is ending up in your food. So I got a stainless steel one. There was only one problem with it, actually two problems. The one problem was it was silver. And so I used some flat black paint to paint it, the same type of paint you would use to paint a charcoal grill. And I just sanded it lightly before I painted it in hopes that that would help the paint stick a little better. And the reason I painted it, of course, is that black absorbs heat, and so I'm hopeful that that will help the efficiency of the oven a little bit. The other problem this little pan had is that it had no handle that I could use to hang it from the chain I have here. So I was able to improvise with a coat hanger to allow me to hang this on the chain. I also made the chain long enough that I can adjust it up and down just by changing it to another link. And I have plenty of leftover here so I can adjust it as far up or down as I need to get it exactly in the focal point. All right, I think I'm gonna go ahead and give this a try. I have it oriented so it's in the focal point. As you notice, I'm not even using the chain. Here on 4th of July with the sun almost directly overhead, it turns out that I can't use the chain to get it over the focal point. So I'm going to have to do it this way and see if I can make it work. I have a hamburger here I'm going to try to cook for you today, so let's see what happens. A little bit of cooking spray to make sure it doesn't, nothing sticks. And I'm going to go ahead and put this in. Sounds like something happening. Go ahead and cover it up and see what happens. All right, it's been about 20 minutes and there's been a few passing clouds, but I think this is pretty much done. All right, I think I've learned a few things today. First of all, I think I'm satisfied with the performance of the oven. I realized that I was only cooking something for one person, but I think based on the size of the dish, that's probably what I can expect. What I didn't like is the way I had arranged to mount the pan. I don't think that's gonna work too well. I don't like the pan being on an angle like that. So I'm going to rig up some sort of a tripod and just hang the pan from that, and hopefully have full range of movement then, so I can put it exactly where I want it and have it level as well. So hopefully I'll be able to do a video of whatever solution I come up with. Thanks for watching today's video, and I'll see you next time.